is communion in Messiah. And in my talk, I always use this now, one of communion in Messiah. Kasi pag minsan, pag communion, we think of sometimes we enjoy each other's company and presence. But when you talk of communion in mission, we have a responsibility to go out. It is like what Pope Francis has written in the Evangelii Gaudium, become missionary disciples. Communion in mission, we are not just disciples following Jesus, but we're also missionary bringing Him to the world. But communion in mission brings out that kind of reflection. Second level natin ngayon is communion in the church. How do we understand? Mahirap mag-BEC pag ang mga tao, mga communities, pamilya natin, kanya-kanya. The diocese, the communion must be expressed in the church. And this is precisely where John Paul II gives us a very different understanding of the universal church and then the local churches. Next, please. Ano itong communion between the universe and local churches? Next, please. Makinas para kay John Paul II, and he's starting, and the popes have been doing this, you know, ang pagtingin sa authority para kay John Paul II, ang authority ng successor of Peter on Pope must not be taken in the canonical or juridical manner. This is not a supremacy in terms of law. For him, ang mahalaga na makita natin dito in the context of communion, leadership and authority becomes a pastoral primacy at the service of the unity of faith. For John Paul II, ang authority ng Pope and down the line, bishops, priests, and down the line is not in the legalistic framework but in the context of pastoral primacy at the service of unity. We are there to serve the unity of God's people as agents of communion. We are not there because we are chosen to be on top. We are there to be at the servant, to be servants of the unity of faith. Para sa kanya, ito ang mahalaga. And then the next is now the communion in the local churches. Ang nakatutuwan din na ngayon, sa usapin simbahan, ang silitang local ngayon ay magandang salita. Ang problema culturally sa Pinoy, basta pinag-usapan local, ang ibig sabihin niyan ay waklas, local ka lang. Ano yan? Walang sinabi, walang pinatupad. Mabuti pa ang Iglesia ni Cristo. May magandang concept ng lokal. Ang mga Iglesia ni Cristo, ang kanilang simbahan pa nila local chapter. Sa San Jose, may siha, sa diocese, ang daming mga local chapter ng Gimba, local chapter ng ganyan, local chapter. They use the word local. Because the word local captures the theology of culture and context. Pakikita mo dito yung lalim, context and culture. Kasi ang simbahan is not a one-size-fits-all. Kasi kung isang basin natin universal, meaning uniform, one-size-fits-all. Isang, but again, ito, bagay sa lahat, lahat itong gagawin. You know, that kind of thinking is not present even among the iglesias. They have to stress the local. The born-again Christians are also more authentic to the understanding. Ang sagnilang ganito yung mga ministries nila. International ministries planted in every street, in every garage, mga second, third floors na mga building. They have a concept of local. Tayo mga Katoliko, sabi nga nung sinabi ni Bishop na quoting Jerry na study ng court electricity, but it's possible. Because kumisan, we don't see the pinch until and unless nayayaling na ang mga tao, puli na ng mga tao, nayayaling na simbahan. So, the word local, therefore, is very important in the theology of the church. Because there can be no church if it is not locally situated. there can be no church if there's no context for being church. As church, we have a context. You have, kasi pasayang ng simbahan, konteksto, kultura, tao. Kasaysayan, sitwasyon, challenges, ano ba yan? Ito yung local church. And this is how John Paul II defined the diocese. Maganda, I think this is a better definition. Sabi ni Pope John Paul II, each particular church must be grounded in the witness of ecclesial communion, which constitutes its very nature as church. The civil fathers chose to describe the diocese as a communion of communities gathered around the shepherd, where clergy, consecrated persons, and the laity are engaged in a dialogue of life and heart, sustained by the grace of the Holy Spirit. It's a beautiful theological definition of what a diocese is. So different from canon law, and so different perhaps from the way we define dioceses back in our home setting in the diocese. It is a communion of communities. And my dear brother, please, this was written in 1998-99. The document has been there, but somehow kulang na, sayang. And regarding around Jesus Christ, so that bishops, clergy, and all of us may engage in a dialogue of life and heart, sustained by the grace of the Holy Spirit. Next, please. Maganda yung kanyang sinasabi dito, no? It is primarily in the diocese that the vision of communal communities can be actualized in the midst of the complex social, political, religious, cultural, and economic realities of Asia. Ecclesial communion implies that each local church should become what the Synod Fathers called a participatory church, a church in which all live their proper vocation and perform their proper role. And in order to build up communion for mission and the mission of communion, every member's unique charism needs to be acknowledged, developed, and effectively utilized. Alam niyo, ang ganda ni makita ko na sa diocese talaga, yung complexity ng situation, kinakailangan makaroon ng participation kasi ang charisma sa mga parokya, sa mga dioceses, sa mga diocese ng mga tao, very concrete, and they are there waiting to be back. I appreciated the diocese of Somosierra when Bishop Bobet, you know, in his own experience of going to the different communities, the parishes, nakita doon, nakita ni Bishop, ang dami-dami mga tricycle drivers, mga magsasaka, indigenous people, elderly, and what they did in their pastoral planning, they had consultations of the different sectors so that the parish pastoral plan is not just an exercise in planning, but the people themselves get engaged in expressing how they see themselves as part of the bigger whole of the church. The second level, the local church, is the parish. Again, maganda, bago natin pag-usapan sa 2 days, maganda yung technical understanding kasi kanya-kanya understanding of what the parish is. Para sa kay John Paul II, in every diocese, the parish remains the ordinary place where the faithful gather to grow in faith, to live the mystery of the ecclesial communion, and to take part in the church's mission. So sinasabi kasi ng iba, pasay na yung parokya. Masyado ka ng parokyal. Yung mga parokyal, utak natin, mga makikitid. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng parokyal. Pag parokyal, makikitid ang isip, pang-prodi, pang-iyanan. Kaya iba sinasabi, kami, iba na kami. We are now trans-parokyal. In theology, trans-parokyal is a contradiction. You know? How can you be trans-parokyal kung ano ka, umiik? Para ba yung kanina yung ibon doon na nilipad-lipad, hindi makagapo-gapo? Habang ko ba nagdadasabay ng Holy Spirit, hindi makababa? It's when you talk of being parochial, it means concretely you have to be in context. You have to be in the situation and setting where people live. And the ordinary place for evangelization is the parish. Because in the parish, nandiyan ang history, kami mga pintakasi tayo, may mga patron saints tayo. May name tayo to help us. It is surrounded with boundaries, with cultures. Nandiyan yung mga tao, magkakaiba. Precisely because of the mystery of ecclesial communion can happen and does happen when people are different and we are there together. Therefore, next please, sabi ni John Paul II, the Synod Fathers urge pastors to devise new and effective ways of shepherding the faithful so that everyone, especially the poor, will feel truly a part of the parish and of God's people as a whole. Pastoral planning with the lay faithful should be a normal feature of all parishes. Dahil sa mga complex din ang sitwasyon sa isang parokya, iba-iba rin ang charism, kinakailangan yung participatory church ay nabigyan ng buhay, at ang pastoral planning ay isang paraan para ang mga tao magkasama-sama sa pagtingin sa problema at gumabay, maggawa ng paraan ng kalukasan sa mga problema ito. Ito ang parish. A community mission of basic Christian communities and other Christian communities in a certain setting. Now, the most basic, ang tinatawag na basic Christian communities as a community mission of families. Alam niyo ang BEC ay hindi ito prayer group, but prayer group is only a cell of BEC. Hindi pa ito masasabi natin na BEC. Masina yung GKK ng Mindanao, the once established by Father Simpson Michael. You know, we had a verification called by NASA, CBCP NASA on BEC way back in 1987, you know, sa Tagaytay. And then he himself would tell the people, hindi pa BEC yan, these are just cell groups leading to BEC. Kasi ang BEC is not individual membership ng tao, kundi by families yan eh. Kasi magkakapitbahay kayo eh. Ang household, kayo magkakapitbahay. Kasi magkakapitbahay, ang membership is may household, yung families na nandoon. And according to John Paul II, the Synod Fathers underline the value of basic ecclesial communities as an effective way of promoting communion and participation in parishes and dioceses and as a genuine force for evangelization. Ang BEC talaga was there set up for evangelization. It is not meant to be a fundraising sa grassroots level. Hindi ito para lamang mataguyod ang mga popular religiosity tulad ng Black Rosary at ng mga stations of the cross during Fridays or again. Hindi ito activity oriented but for evangelization. Kung kaya, then is a genuine force kasi ang daming magagawa sa level ng magkakapitbahay. At ang next place, at ang inspiration nito is what Monsignor Jerry and Bishop Obet have said. Ang inspiration niya ay ang Acts of the Apostles. Ang BEC ay hindi kinopya sa Latin America sa inyong bayan. Kundi ang inspiration nito ay ang simbahan na nagsimula after the resurrection event, the Acts of the Apostles. Ito ang BEC. We will look at that later on how to go about it. Ngayon, the most basic will be the families as domestic church. It's a communion mission of persons. We have to stress this in Familiaris Consortio, si John Paul II again. Kaya maganda rin, magandang ipali ang mga ideas ni John Paul II. Familiaris Consortio, sabi niya, the first function of a family is to be at the service of persons. Kasi ang pagiging tao natin, nagsimula niya sa tahanan. Kaya maski na ngayon, given the different configurations of families, iba-ibang setup ng families ngayon. May mga third sex na they're cutting sila na anak sa by surrogate. They become fathers and mothers or whichever. You know, it's setup ngayon. Iba-ibang setup ng families. Solo parent, single parent, divorce, ang dami ngayon. Ano man yung setup ng families, it must be, as a domestic church, a community and mission of persons, helping and respecting. And the next piece, and here we have the quotation from the Danish Consortium. Now, ito yung ating tinatawag na parabang diocese as the law, as the community mission of parish, of parishes and other communities. The parish as a community mission of BECs and other additional communities, the BECs as a community mission of persons, of families, and the family as a community mission of persons. Paba natin pagtutugtugin? Ito nga ang sinasabi, ang mahalaga ay mag-focus tayo at supportahan natin ang BEC. Lalo-lalo na sa mga associations, mga organizations, charismatic groups, Monsignor Jenny mentioned about transparochial communities, ano man mga communities na ito that are serving the parishes, we must orient them towards the BEC. Next, please. So, the first kind of small ecclesial communities ay ang mga associational, functional, or charismatic communities. Yung mga sa parokya natin, mga ministries, mga religious organizations, transparochial communities, kanya-kanyang ano yan, pananaw, kanya-kanyang estilo. Kung kaya sinasabi ng PCP2 that these organizations and communities must be organized in the spirit of BEC. That they themselves are not just functioning as organizations, but the spirit of additional life like BEC must be in them and among them. Mahalaga yan. Because they are organized according to needs and interests. Alam nyo, ang hirap. I've been in the parish space for 47 years, and I'm telling you, napakahirap i-orient ang mga yan. Even in the parishes where I was assigned, napakahirap. Mabuti pa magsimula ka magbungkal ng lupa sa grassroots and you like to spring. Itong mga communities na ito, ang hirap buhayin. Mahirap isingin ang mga nagtutulungan. Yan. Ang pangalawang form ng Ecclesial Communion ay ang basic Ecclesial Communities. And here we are talking of one territorial or neighborhood. Magkakapit bahay. Okay? Na may cultural contiguity, cultural closeness. Meron silang intimacy. Alam nila kung ang amoy ng niluluto sa kanila ay alam. Doon sa BF homes, alam niyo, mga subdivisions, I have 44 BECs. Kasi bawat subdivision doon, ginawa akong BEC. Kasi doon, dalawa lamang ang depressed areas namin. So, iba ang approach namin doon, iba din sa mga subdivisions. Iba din ba yan? Doon sa UP, very complex ang aming setup doon. We have areas. We have 17 areas where the faculty members live and their families at ang mga borders. So we made them, bawat area, BEC. But the thing naman sa mga dormitories, again, different pa naman yan. Kasi the dormitorians live there 10 months a year, 6 days a week. So, mahaga their own life. So we have BEC, dormitory BEC. Bawat college, we have the Division of Catholic Action organizing college. So ang approach then would differ. Kaya kailangan cultural, territorial. May pagsasamahan. And then it must be a natural environment and a system. Hindi siya para ba, kayo dito ha, kami dito. Hindi ko ano yung natural. It is a system. Kasi iba ginagawa artificial ang organization na BEC. I remember sa place like St. James Ayala Labang, when Senior Jenny here. When they, you know, St. James Ayala Labang has BDCs, and you know, in Monsignor Looy, there are about 12 districts. Bawat district, mga 300 families or so, talaga na organization, neighborhood, they have Fridays of Lent, stations at the cross, they have activities ongoing, helping the neighborhood community. Yung ganyang klaseng situation. It's also a total ministry. And hindi ito para bang, oh, kasal lang tayo. Hindi ito social action lang, ha? Hindi puro binderasal. Hindi, kundi, to be true to his ecclesial identity, kinakailangan ang mga DECs na ito has the divinely, priestly, and the prophetic. In order for them to become self-producing, self-propelling, and self-nourishing. Ito yung mahalaga. It's a total ministry. Hindi ito isang organization that will do one task. No, they have the complete exercise of the ministries. In some parishes, it's organized according to may barangay muna to coordinate the DECs, may block, may streets. Okay? Urban scenarios. Urban scenarios is a term used by the Synod of Bishops on the new evangelization, and one of the propositions that was approved was the church must try urban scenarios. I am now occupying a unit, say some condo at SM, near the school where I study French. Just go, ang mga condominiums ngayon, ang talagang pwedeng gawing DEC. Kasi talagang, ano sila talagang, it's complete, no? Complete. Kaya ibang mga parishes, they have masses in the condo kasi 7 days a week, they are there. Mga offices, I remember June Palafox invited me to say, to give the collection to his staff on the 14th floor. Pagdating ko doon, mga noontime, nakita ko ba naman mga nag-istasyon ng cruise doon from the first floor to the 14th floor. Tapos pagpunta mo yung bawat floor, may mga santo na nandoon, may mga devotions. May nagpapalisa, no? Today, there are urban scenarios. You know, hospitals, you can have hospital school system, where people gather together. You know, you try to put ecclesial life among them, ecclesial communion. It is our faith that brings people together, not just work or trabaho lang. And then the role of next piece is the role of renewal movements. Ang maganda kay John Paul II, he recognized na ang mga marami sa mga nasa ano natin, Couples for Christ, Vision Family Movement, Ligay ng Panginoon, lahat ng mga ito na mga grupo, they have helped our lay people very much. They have helped our people, especially, sabi nga ni Pope John Paul II dito, they are given opportunities for a more intimate experience of God through faith and the sacraments in fostering conversion of life. Maraming na-convert ang mga tao sa inyo. I think we have to give credit to these movements. However, next please, ito lang ang warning ni John Paul II. Okay? Ang warning niya, those involved in associations and movements should offer their support to the local church and not present themselves as alternatives to the diocesan structure and parish life. Ang mahalaga, sila mismo sumuporta kasi nga among themselves ay talaga ay mahihirapan. Kung kaya ito ang parang masasabi natin, anong challenges? Please, the third part's challenges. Here I come to and no longer speak of John Paul II. Basically here, I like to quote Pope Francis. The call of Pope Francis to total conversion in the pursuit of church as communion mission of communities. Next, please. sa karanasan ng mga BEC practitioners, ito'y nangyari noong 2 years ago, the first National Assembly of BECs happened here in Paco Catholic School. There were more than 1,000 delegates all over the Philippines. And last day, Sio of Solidarity, about 10,000 people gathered sa Cuneta Astrodome. At doon sa assembly, nagkaroon ng alinaw-naw talagang lakas ng sentimento. Nag-report ang mga organization, ang mga BECs at ibang parts ng Philippines, ang word na naging controversial, and some bishops didn't take it well, ay ang problema namin ngayon, sabi ng mga tao, may mga BEC lovers na mga pare, at mga BEC killers na mga pare. Dalawang unit ng pare mayroon, BEC killers or BEC lovers. Sabi niya, napakadaling patayin ang BEC. Mahirap buhayin, magbigay buhay, mahirap pag namatay na, mahirap mas mahirap buhayin, napakadaling patayin. I was an experience of that. Doon sa UP, Paris of the Holy Sacrifice, ginawa ko yung ginawa ni Father Delaney. Mga bahay, pinuntahan ko, nakikain ako sa street mass, sama-sama sa Rosano, nagkaroon ng leadership, formation and training, ang mga leaders, lahat ng ganyan. Dumating isang kapalit ko doon. Ang unang niyang ginawa, no masses in the areas, sa gitna lamang ng simbahan. Yung mass na yung means for the community to be gathered together, wala na yun. At ang sabi niya sa mga tao, kayo, paghumpanin mo sa inyo, Delaney, Monsignor Gabriel, ni Father Delaney, Monsignor Gabriel, nandiyan pa kayo. Ang tatandaan niya, magpapalit tayo ng mga leaders, meron tayo ng leadership training ng mga bagong leaders. Inilis yung mga leaders. Sa awa ng Diyos, walang pinagin na leaders. Without the mass and without the leaders, the community died. Ang daling mag-BEC killers. Ang daling. Babuhin mo lamang yung sistema na dinagdag mo sa parokya, pagpapalitan ng pare. Napakadali, wala na yung BEC mo. Goodbye, BEC. That's why BEC must be a commitment of the whole diocese with a vision and mission statement guiding you. Without that, at ang pare-pare, mapag-aaway ang pare sa bawat isa. Kaya itong ginagawa natin yung niwag BEC, it affects the whole diocese, the whole parish, and not just the BECs. How do we sustain that? Ang unang challenge ni Pope Francis ay, one, missionary conversion. From a pastoral strategy of maintenance to a pastoral position that is truly missionary. Kay Pope Francis, ang ganda sabi na, maintain mo nilang istruktura, pagkapagagawa ng guro. Mahirap mag-BEC, magtuturo ka sa mga tao, nag-aadal ka ng Biblia, hindi ka naman speaking scholar, hindi ka naman pwedeng magkaroon ng liturgical adoration, hindi ka liturgies, hindi ka pwedeng mag-catechize, kasi hindi ka naman catechize. Ano ka? Wala lang. Once you are a shepherd in the BEC, you have to be a missionary. How is this attained? One, according to Pope Francis, no to staying in the center of power. I do not want a church concerned with their being at the center and then ends by being caught in the web of possessions and procedures. Tingnan ninyo ang mga nasa sentro ng power ng parokya. Ang tinitingnan, ano meron tayo, ano wala tayo, at anong meron tayo ng gagawin, anong procedure. Lahat, kaya magbawat sigit ng kumbento malinis. You are caught into that wall. But if you go precisely, you know, then note the exclusivism and exclusion. Note the complacency or attitude that says, we have done it this way, it was good. Why fix, if it ain't broke, why change it? Okay naman yun eh. Yan lang. Note an obsession with the disjointed transmission of doctrines to be easily imposed. Alam niyo, misan, lalo niyo kung sa mga bishop. I am the canon law and the canon lawyer. Ngayon bumaba na ang parish priest. I am the canon law and the canon lawyer. Ayoko ng parish council. Walang parish council. Ako ang president ng parish council. Kayo, kasawa niya. You have all these kinds of strange theology or, you know, interpretation of the law that makes you a missionary. And then not to be in lay administrators. These are the words of Pope Francis. They are not mine. They are not mine. How do you become a missionary? Yes, to reaching out to the excluded and marginalized. Excluded. Yes, to welcoming everyone without exception. If you analyze the church, why people need the church and why people have issues with the church, it is because they are always treated unfairly. Yes, to being bold and creative in the task of rethinking the goals, structures, styles, and methods of evangelization in the respective community. Be a shepherd among your flock. And coming home is smelled like the sheep. For John, for Francis, this is the yardstick of being a missionary. The next is ecclesial conversion versus ecclesial introversion. Kasi misa sa simbahan, but yun at yun din ang nangyayari, we become introverted. It's our own interest, the interest of the church. You know, I remember yung dito sa parokya ko sa resurrection, talagang my first 2 years, hirap kami. Ang hirap magkatak ng tao sa misa kasi sa San Beta, aircon, yung sila nagsisimba. Yung simbahan namin, kaunti ang nagsisimba. Pagkatapos ay sasabihin ko ng mga tao, ang hihihili sa mundo dyan. So, tapos walang center for people's meeting. Nag-meeting mo yan sa Jollibee, sa McDonald's, sa Big Plate. Wala kami center doon. So talagang yung simbahan namin, kawawa naman. Napakadali na pala ng solusyon. So, we got permission from the bishop. Nagpagawa ako ng aircon. We raised 12 million in 2 months. Napaayos yung aircon. Pinaayos yung simbahan. Raised about 20 million. You know, with the changes, the population of mass goers has increased to 30%. And collection has gone to 40%. Ano sikreto? Aircon. Akala ba something dramatic, something, no? Only really because the people have the need. Now, children go to church, we have an infant care room. People, infants, care room, go on. We now have a mass for the autistic children, for special children, for deaf mute. Every 9:30 mass, the autistic children sing. You know, those with Down syndrome would serve at mass. It's their mass. The children's mass, their dance mass. If all of a sudden you realize, when you don't become introverted thinking, ang mahal-mahal niyan, nakasus ka na malaki dyan, tapos ano bang income dyan, ganyan. You know, we realize that the more you give to the people, the more people give back. You realize that it's their own need. Itong pag-alis ko lang, ang dami-daming drama. Yung ang drama ng maganda sa lahat ng mga millennials. They come to church ngayon in shorts, all the bololoy, ganyan. Father, thank you for what you have done to us. Akala ko, wow, something evangelical, you know, wow. Father, you echoed the church and you made it a prayer conditioned church. Father, that's all we'll remember you about. Nothing about how beautiful the home is, nothing of that. Napakayos in bahay. You know, it's a simple thing like that na we might think. Pero it's, you're not thinking of the church, but the people, the need, That is the thing that's important. Ecclesial conversion is for us to think church, to think people. The sensus fidelium, always being what the faithful people would need. And then the third is, challenge is the priority of the evangelization. And for Pope Francis, this is simply three things. New evangelization is experiencing Christ as the center of our personal life and our faith. Christ is the center. The charisma, the good news, experiencing Christ, encountering Him. And the second is to go and reach out to those whose hearts are far away from the church. And my brother priests, so many have left the church wounded. Dissolution with the church. You know, to me, the hardest thing is to win them back because they don't see a church as compassionate to reach out to them. That's why in the new evangelization, reconciliation is a very important move that Pope Francis has expressed. And then, at the same time, renewal of the church. These are the three things of the new evangelization. And the key strategy is go to the streets, next please, and offer everyone the life of Jesus Christ. Francis says, I prefer a church that is bruised, hurting, and dirty because it has been out on the streets rather than a church which is unhealthy from being confined and clinging to its own security. We need the church to be out in the street, dealing with people. Next, please. Next, please. And the method of evangelization, I like what was read by Father for the beginning. The method of evangelization, to me, as catechist and in charge of the catechetical formation in your respective parishes, you know, Pope Francis has given us two icons of how to accompany people in our life of faith. How to do catechesis today in our time. Catechesis that is evangelizing. Catechesis that's not imposing ideas, but evangelizing, warming the hearts of people. And the two icons are one, the Good Samaritan. You know, to me, the Good Samaritan, Southern Pope Francis, if you want the church to be credible to the people of our time, we have to be a Good Samaritan. Once we give your all, give your best, and attend to the victims of so much violence today, to him, this is the way to catechize now. Giving their very best and accompanying people in their journey of faith. Next, please. And then the second icon that he has given is the two disciples of Emmaus. Again, what I like here is the way Pope Francis describes people in the dark night of their journey. People are doubting their faith, people who are lost and depressed in life, people who cannot take heads and tails out of their own crosses. And yung sinasabi niya, ang ganda, I just read it. Sabi niya, it is a fact that nowadays there are many people, like the two disciples of Emmaus, that only those looking for answers in the new religious groups that are sprouting out, but also those who are already seen godless, both in theory and in practice. We need a church. We need a church unafraid of going forth into their night. We need a church capable of meeting them on their way. We need a church capable of entering into their conversation. So my dear brother priest, these are the challenges that await us as we build communion of communities. Thank you.
Questions? Thank you, Monsignor. We have